Can you? You cannot start the video. Host has stopped.
No, no, you can start the video right now. You are a panelist now. Just a minute. Make a co-host. Now I think you can on the video. Yes.
Hello. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Rahul Chaudhary, and welcome to this new ABC webinar. For our members, every time we do arrange various kind of platforms to promote business opportunities and related skills. Today, the topic is RoadTech Export Promotion Scheme. And we have Vinayak ji with us, who will lead us and guide related export promotion schemes. Now I request Vinayak sir, please start the program.
For our members, every time we do arrange various kind of platforms to promote business opportunities and related skills. Today the topic is RoadTech Export Promotion Scheme, and we have Vinayak ji with us, who will lead us and guide related export promotion schemes. Now I request Vinayak sir, please start the program.
So thank you very much, Justin. So thank you very much, Rahul ji. Okay, so thank you very much, Rahul ji, for your nice introductions and giving me opportunity to share my views and knowledge about RoadTech. It is a new export promotion scheme. So all are welcome here. So I will share my screen and express my humble gratitude to all who has come to join, and in very short time you are attending these sessions, and you are having a approach of learning. I really like people who are eager to learn the new things and grow in their life. There is the only way to grow in life, that is learn. There is the only way to earn money or earn wealth, that is the only way to learn. If you have a Saraswati, Lakshmi will follow you. So again, welcome to you all. And again, express my sincere gratitude to IBC. They organize such types of knowledge session to industry since long. And they're having more than 3,000 members of their business group from various across the country. So again, thank you. And so we will start the sessions. I'll share my screen. Can you see this presentation? You can put it in chat box. Can you see this? Yes, Rahul says yes, Siddharth says yes. So before going to start the sessions, I would like to ask you the questions. What is your what do you understand by new RoadTech export promotion scheme? That is the first questions. What is your understanding about new RoadTech export promotion scheme? You can put it in chat box. What do you understand by RoadTech export promotion scheme? Anybody? You can put it in chat box. Not heard before. Okay, no problem. If you are not heard, that is also okay. But anybody understand what is RoadTech? If you don't have, no need to worry. The replacement of Bhagya Lakshmi, you are perfectly right. It is a replacement of MEIS. Perfect. Anybody? Anybody? You can put it in chat box. I want to understand. Okay, no, Ramesh says no, no problem if you don't know. So coming to your next, my next question to you, what is your expectation from these sessions? What do you expect from these sessions? What do you expect from these sessions? What is your expectation from these sessions? Learn something new, Rahul, perfect, anybody? Anybody? Everything about Roadtap, okay. Understand the scheme difference from MES perfect, Manoj says. Anybody? I am new, no problem. Ramesh, no problem if you are new, no problem. We are covering from the basics. We are covering some basics points, so you do not need to worry. New to this, no problem, Siddharth. So, okay, thank you for your feedback. So we are going to have a one more third questions through poll. Just you have to put your opinion. I just want to understand the your profile. So I am going to ask you the questions. How many are into export import business, working executive, student or fresher? Just give your, it is a just poll I have launched. I want to understand whether are you already into export import business, working executive, student or fresher. Just give your feedback. Okay. Around 42. Okay. I want your, still there are pendings. I want feedback from the rest of the people. 50% has given the, they have done the voting. I want 100% voting from all the groups. Still pending. Okay. Still there is a pending of few. So here data says around 20% participants are already into export and import business. Around 42% are working executive and around 30% are fresher and student. So no problem. We will cover, we'll ensure that everybody will understand these subjects. Also, we are at the end of the sessions. We are covering how to connect with the international buyers. So these are the point we are going to cover at the end of the sessions. So be there. If you have any questions, you can put it in chat box. Because we are having time of 40 to 50 minutes. So we want to cover all the points in 40 to 50 minutes. Subject is little bit, we can say challenging, new, because this scheme is new. A lot of things are still happening and has been happening since last 2 years. So we'll start the sessions. So thank you very much for participating in the poll. Thank you very much. So coming to our slides, what will be our flow of the sessions? Expectation profile just now we have discussed. What is the objective and visions? India's contribution to against world GDP, actual facts and figures of export material services and balance of payment, various export incentive schemes, various taxes merged under GST, Roadtap principles, schemes and rates, how to avail export incentive, challenges of exporters, and various way to get connected with the buyers and our support ship and review and Q&A. So there are some points which are basics, whoever is a new to this export and import. So don't worry, everything will cover and we are sure that you will get a value for your time within a 40 to 50 minutes. So if you have any questions, no problem. You can put, my chat box is open. You can put it in chat box. I will respond to your chat box. I'll reply to your chat box if you have any questions. So we'll start the sessions. Again, thank you very much for your patience. Be there 40 to 50 minutes. It is a sessions and there are 50 to 60 slides are there. So we are going to cover as fast as possible. If you have any questions, you can put it in chat box so that I will give the clarification on it. Okay. So we'll start the sessions. So what is our vision? Our vision, IBC is a business networking platform, and 24 Mile is providing export import services. So our objective is to support entrepreneurs to develop sustainable export business. Here sustainable word is very important, because doing a one or two times of export, it is not called as an export. Export has to be sustainable. It should be regular. It should be on monthly 9 to 10 shipments. Then it is called as a sustainable export business, because doing one or two times of shipment, it is not a challenge. Anybody can do it. Our vision is to make export rich India and develop India's economic contribution to the world GDP from 10% to 40% as on December 2040. So this is our vision. So if you see the last 2000 years graph, our 2000 year back, our India's contribution to world GDP was around 40%. And if you see the now, it is around 9 to 10%. And Japan's contribution also 9 to 10%. Going to the next slide, you can see India's population is around 139 crore and our trillion dollar economy is 305. And Japan's population is only 12.6 crore and their trillion dollar economy is 5.38. So here we need to think on it. Our population and their our population and Japanese population and their trillion dollar economy and their contribution to the world GDP. We have to think on that and what individual can how can I can contribute to the our economy so that we will become an export rich India. So this is our vision. So I'm just sharing this map just to understand where we are now and where is the Japan stands against the world GDP. It is basic things everybody needs to understand so that everybody will get a vision, goal, individual goal, because if individuals started contributing to our economy, then definitely we'll become an export rich India. So this is our vision. So that share this slide. Is that okay? Are you getting this slide? Because I give very importance to this slide. This will give the clarity where we stand and what we have to do as an individual so that we will reach, we'll become an export rich India. Are you getting this slide? I want your response. Okay, Manoj. Very good. Okay, Bhagyalakshmi, very good. So coming to the how, what is our actions? What IBC and 24 mile take the initiative to make a sustainable export business? We have taken the initiatives to get connected with the non-resident of India, NRI, overseas frames, international buyer, chamber of commerce and embassy with free of cost. Because to make an export rich India, IBC or suppose we have decided to start our own export, then it will not achieve. We can reach up to 1,000, 2,000, 5,000 crore exports. But if you support to the society, to the MSME with the help of our initiative, so definitely we can achieve a vision of export rich India. So this is the initiative IBC and 24 mile is taking. And we are supporting to MSME, new entrepreneurs, to connect with the overseas friends, international buyer, chamber of commerce and embassy and NRI. So this is our actions to make a sustainable export business development of our India and of our individual person. So this is our actions and this is the initiative we are taking. This webinar is also one of the activity of these initiatives. So we'll discuss, we'll see what is the actual facts and figures so that we will get an idea. So where we stand it. So if you see our merchant, there are two types of exports. One is a merchandise export. Merchandise export means material export. Second one is a service export. We will see the data of the financial year 2020-21. Our export was 21,54,339 crore and our import was 29 lakhs. So total trade imbalance, trade difference is 7,55,597 crore is the difference in material import and exports. It is into merch. It is called merchandise export. If you see the yearly trend of merchandise export from 2014 to 15, so this is a gap. Here our export is 18.96 lakh crore and our import is 27,37,000 crore. So this is the gap. If you see this gap is the same since last 5 to 6 years. So our job is to that gap has to be reduced and make our country, make our India more export oriented so that that gap will reduce and we'll get a more foreign exchange as compared to we can pay our import cost. So this is, and also if you see the service export data of last financial year, we are into surplus. If you see the data of 15-16, our service import was 5,54,000 and our service export was 10,10,500 crore. That was a service export. So we are into surplus into service exports. So I would like to ask you the one question. So what is our core competency? Where we are strong? If you see the data of the financial year 2020-21, merchandise and services, so where we are strong? Amit, there are, I will try to speak in both language, English and Hindi, because there are some participants are from South India, so they do not understand the Hindi. So difference क्या है service export में और merchandise export में, which हमारा core competency, हमारा country का core competency कौन सा है, what data shows? Services perfect, Mallikarjun says perfect, services हमारा ये है क्या, services हमारा core, India का core competency. So there are various ways of services like software services, yoga, you can also give the consultancy, medical consultancy, yoga services, engineering services. So there are a lot of services there. You can also start. I always give the example of yoga services. You can learn the yoga and you can give yoga services through online platform to the overseas, our NRI, overseas countries people. And you can be a service exporter without any investment. I always give this example of yoga and consultancy, whatever specialty you are having, that services you can give it to the NRI or overseas people so that you can be a service exporter. So this is the easiest, and without any investment you can start. Also, if you are an accountant, you can also start giving accounting services to overseas country. Like in Indonesia, there are a lot of our CAs are there, and we are providing, all Indian, many Indians are providing accounting outsourcing services to Indonesia country. So this is the things I would like to share. Coming to the next point, what is the balance of payment? We should understand the balance of payment, then we are going to the next step. Balance of payment means it is a country's record of all economic transactions between the resident of a country and rest of the world in a particular period. It is called balance of payment. And what is the importance of that balance of payment? It examines the transaction of all exports and imports of goods and services for a given period. It helps the government to analyze the potential of a particular industry export growth and formulate policy to support the growth. Balance of payment, it is a record of the all export and import goods and services. So it indicates whether our import is more or export is more. So understand, if you are new to this export and import, you must understand what is the balance of payment. Then you will be able to understand where we stand and what we have to do. So going to the next step, we'll see the July's data of balance of payment. You can see merchandise means material export. Data says ki $35.43 million is a billion dollar is a export, and import is $46.4 billion. So there is a trade imbalance is -10.97. This is almost $11 billion is a deficit in balance of payment. And if you see the service export, again, it is a service export. Our export is $19.52 billion and our import is $10.889 billion. And we are into surplus into service export. That is $8.64 billion. We are a surplus. But overall, if you add it overall trade of merchandise and service export, we are into deficit of $2.34 billion. So we have to focus on the more export, and we have to work on the import substitution so that we will be in a surplus position of the foreign exchange. So this was the July month data. Also, we have done the comparative of 2020-19. So this will help you to understand what, if you want to contribute to our economy, what action as an individual to be. आपको सपोज इसमें अमित जी सपोज ये डिफरेंस है हमारा जो मटेरियल एक्सपोर्ट और इंपोर्ट है उसमें 10.97 डिफरेंस है डेफिसिट है इन द मंथ ऑफ जुलाई 2021 ओके और सर्विस एक्सपोर्ट जो होता है उसमें हम $8.6 billion में सरप्लस है लेकिन ओवरऑल जुलाई महीने का हमारा ये देखेंगे ट्रेड देखेंगे तो हम $2.34 billion में माइनस में है डेफिसिट में तो ये इट विल गिव एन आइडिया फिर भी हम इसलिए आइडिया मिल जाएगा कि हमारा देश का क्या करना चाहिए कहां फोकस करना चाहिए तो हम जो इंपोर्ट कर रहे हैं तो इंपोर्ट कैसे कम कर सकते हैं कैन यू हम इंपोर्ट के लिए सब्स्टिट्यूट फाइंड आउट कर सकते हैं कि नहीं सकते तो ये हमें आइडिया आ जाएगा इसलिए आई एम गिविंग द फिगर इज दैट ओके अमित इज दैट ओके अंडरस्टूड नाउ इज दैट ओके अमित सो ये डिफरेंस है सो कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट सो व्हाट इज द रोल ऑफ आवर मिनिस्ट्री There is a commerce ministry है, finance ministry है, these are the two ministry. Finance ministry का role क्या होता है कि to collect the revenue, custom, GST, income tax, these types of taxes to collect the revenue. It is a role of the finance ministry. Also, there is a deficit in the balance of payment. Just now we have saw कि there is a deficit in the balance of payment. तो हमें foreign exchange buy करना, dollar we have to buy it to make a payment of the importer payment. तो ये deficit है, इसलिए commerce role of the commerce ministry is to design the policy. such a way that so that we can our people will get motivated and they will focus on the export. So role of the commerce ministry is to design the export policy, and their objective is to promote the export so that ye jo balance of payment mein deficit hai, that will get reduced or will go into surplus. So is that okay? Yahan tak aapko samajh mein aaya everybody? Aapko samajh mein aaya balance of payment? Just I'm creating a basic background to go to the road tab and list. Okay, thank you Manoj. Anybody? Amit ji, have you understand? Have you understood? Balance of payment mein deficit hai, matlab hamara import is more. So hame import jyada hai to hame kya karna padta hai? We have to buy the foreign currency. USD हमें बाय करना पड़ता है, तो उसलिए हमें पेमेंट करना पड़ता है. तो कॉमर्स मिनिस्ट्री का रोल क्या है? टू डिजाइन द एक्सपोर्ट पॉलिसी और ऑब्जेक्टिव्स टू प्रमोट एक्सपोर्ट. तो एक कॉमर्स मिनिस्ट्री का रोल है, इसलिए वो क्या करते हैं कॉमर्स मिनिस्ट्री? व्हाट डज कॉमर्स मिनिस्ट्री? दे डिजाइन पॉलिसी एंड पॉलिसी ऐसे एक्सपोर्ट इंसेंटिव डिजाइन करते हैं. तो रोड टैब इज वन ऑफ द स्कीम टू प्रमोट द एक्सपोर्ट्स. आर यू गेटिंग दिस अमित जी? Are you getting this point? Are you getting this point? Okay, so we'll move on to the next point. So what are the various export incentive scheme kya hai, benefits kya kya hai? One road tab is a remission of duties and taxes on export products. We are going to discuss in details. If you have any question, you can put it in chat box. Ramesh, you have raised the hand, so you can, if you have any questions, you can put it in chat box. Not to worry. There is also ROSTL, that is rebate of state and central levies and taxes for export of made on articles and garments. This scheme is for textiles. So there is also this scheme for textiles. There is also one more scheme, that is service export from India scheme. It is again service, whatever service you export, except software export. And still they have not given the confirmation for this new financial year, so that will come from the foreign trade policy key, what is the current, whether it is applicable or not. There is also one more scheme, that is a drawback. It is around 2% on the FOB value. There is also one more scheme, that like a export promotional capital goods. When we import capital goods, in that case we can import without paying a 30% duty, subject to export obligations we can import. That is also incentive. Also, there is a advance authorization scheme, that is when we import the raw material, we can import without payment of import duty. Again, subject to, we have to fulfill some export obligations. There is also one more scheme, like a market access initiative and market development initiative. In that case, suppose any exhibition is funded by the government of India, so that when we take the participate in when we go overseas and take a stall and participate in that exhibition, we can avail airfare to and fro, plus you will get discounted rate of stall, or sometimes you will get 100% reimbursement of stall cost. So this is also one of the incentive. Also one more incentive, or we can say benefit, suppose there is a import duty of 30%, we can buy the license from any other exporters, and we can avail the 1-2% discount. We can buy it at the rate of 1-2% discount, and we can get the benefit of 1-2% import duty. So these are the various export incentive benefits for all the exports activity, export and import activity. So coming to our point, what is the role of the World Trade? If you want to understand the road tab, you should understand what is the role of the World Trade Organizations. So it is very important to understand the World Trade Organization and what they are doing. The World Trade Organization is an intra-governmental organization that regulates and facilitates international trade between nations. It has also replaced the GATT that had been established in 1948. The WTO is the world's largest international economic organization with 160 member states, representing over 96% of global trade and global GDP. What is the principle of the World Trade Organization? Actually, this World Trade Organization set up, their objective is to trade has to be streamlined. There should not be any non-discrimination. One more principle of the World Trade Organization follow, that is reciprocity. Means the practice of exchanging the things with other for mutual benefit, especially privilege granted by one country or organization to another. Because if you see the world, there are more than 200 countries. There are some countries are developed country, some countries are developing country, and some countries are underdeveloped country. Suppose there are some countries which are underdeveloped country. If you could give them a subsidy or incentives, then their product will be competitive in the global market. There are some developed country, they are having a technology, they are having everything. So their cost will be competitive, so that underdeveloped country or developing country will not compete in the global market, and they will not be able to make exports. They will not be able to make an export oriented country, export rich country. So that what is the role of the World Trade Organization is to ensure that country who is economically weaker, let them allow to give the export incentive to that country. If that country is developed country, make them enforceable binding so that they cannot give the incentive. So that since last 2 years, WTO is pressurizing Indian government to remove all the incentives since last 2 years, but due to COVID and all these things, government has not taken any decisions. So since 1st January 2021, they have removed the merchandise export India scheme because of WTO has clearly said, please distort this direct subsidy to the exporter because your Indian product is becoming more competitive and cheaper, so that other countries, underdeveloped countries, are unable to compete in the global market. Are you getting this point? Do you have any question regarding this? But do you want any more clarification, explanation? I'll explain in Hindi. World Trade Organization ka role hai ki to facilitate the global trade. 96% more than 160 members hai, members country hai World Trade Organization ka. To unka role hai ki 96% global trade jo country members hai unke through globally hota hai WTO ka. WTO ka role aisa hai ki jo underdeveloped country hai उनको सपोर्ट करना चाहिए, क्योंकि उनको सपोर्ट नहीं करेंगे तो डेवलप कंट्री के पास टेक्नोलॉजी होता है, फंडिंग होता है, तो उनका प्रोडक्ट विल बी बिकम मोर चीपर. उनका प्रोडक्ट चीपर हो गया तो क्या हो सकता है, जो डेवलप कंट्री का प्रोडक्ट चीपर हो गया तो जो अंडर डेवलप कंट्री है दे कैनॉट कॉम्पीट इन द ग्लोबल ट्रेड और वो ग्रो नहीं हो जाएंगे, इकोनॉमिकली स्ट्रेंथन नहीं हो जाएंगे. जो वीकर कंट्री है उसको सपोर्ट करना है, इट इज अ जॉब ऑफ द WTO. So, उन्होंने लिखा है वन ऑफ द प्रिंसिपल कि द प्रैक्टिस ऑफ एक्सचेंजिंग द थिंग्स विद अदर्स फॉर म्यूचुअल बेनिफिट स्पेशली प्रिविलेज ग्रांटेड बाय वन कंट्री टू ब्रिंगिंग द ट्रांसपेरेंसी. और जो डेवलप कंट्री उनके ऊपर बाइंडिंग एंड एनफोर्सेबल कुछ कमिटमेंट करना. तो ये जो है MEIS के लिए उन्होंने फोर्स किया था, प्लीज रिमूव इट, प्लीज डिसॉर्ट डायरेक्ट सब्सिडी टू द इंडियन एक्सपोर्टर. उन्होंने गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया को एनफोर्सेबल कमिटमेंट किया था. सो दिस इज द रोल ऑफ द WTO. आर यू गेटिंग दिस पॉइंट? अभी मैंने आई हैव एक्सप्लेन अगेन. आर यू गेटिंग दिस WTO का पॉइंट? ओके सिद्धार्थ, थैंक यू. सो वील मूव टू द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट. सो कमिंग टू आवर पॉइंट, that is RoDTEP. What is a RoDTEP? It is a remission of duties and taxes on exported products and scheme. So we'll discuss in detail what is the difference. And this scheme has been effected from the 1st January 2021. Earlier it has been replaced by the Merchandise Export India scheme. So what is this scheme? It is a provided rate of benefits applicable to on 8,555 tariff lines, and benefits given on percentage on FOB or fixed amount per unit of measurement. We'll discuss in detail during the next sessions. So what is the difference between MEIS and RoDTEP? MEIS was to incentivize the export of the goods from India. MEIS ka role tha ki incentivize karna, this was the benefit. MEIS was to incentivize the export of the goods from India, and RoDTEP is a neutralize the taxes and duties suffered on exported goods which are otherwise not credited or remitted or refunded in any manner. Wo hum discuss detail mein karenge, what is the neutralize the taxes and kaun sa duties hai, that we'll discuss in detail. Just first understand what is the difference. देन विल गो इन टू डिटेल्स कि कौन सा न्यूट्रलाइज टैक्सेस हो रहा है. Subject is little bit people who are new, participants who are new, it will be little bit difficult, but listen that, and at the end of the session you can ask me the questions. So what is the difference between MEIS and roadmap? First difference is it is a part of the free foreign trade policy. Benefits given as per the export incentive under foreign trade policy, benefits given as a duty exemption and remission scheme under foreign trade policy. It is an incentive and it is a duty exemption remission. So this is the first difference. Products, almost all the products were covered under MEIS benefit. There are few sectors, that is pharmaceutical, chemical, steels are important sectors which have not been covered in the scheme as on today. So this is the first second difference. Benefit, the average rate of benefit under MEIS was between 2 to 7%. And roadmap may the benefit range between 0.01 to 4.3% of FOB value. However, in majority of the products, benefit under roadmap is substantially lower than MEIS benefit. So this is the difference. Restriction, MEIS was broad-based scheme which was available to SEZ, EOU, MOOR, advance authorization holder, etc. Roadmap is very restrictive, and SEZ and EOU advance authorization holder, MOOR, etc. have been covered in the ineligible categories, with an option for some of this confer benefit in future. So this is very limited. Country specific, the quantum of benefit depend upon the country of export. Export to some of the countries were not entitled for benefits. In roadmap, there are no country specific restriction. Export to all the countries are covered in the scheme benefits. New impact, the benefit under MEIS for majority of sector was significant compared to roadmap, and help a lot of exporter to become a competitive in the international market. This was the impact. And the benefit under roadmap is very restrictive, and in many sectors may have adverse impact on the export competitiveness of the Indian exporters. So do you have any question regarding this? If you understand this, then roadmap is almost you will understand. Do you have any questions against this? So we are going to cover what is the taxes part, will cover in next slides. Have you understood this? Anybody? Okay, sir, can you explain? Just a minute. Can you explain with some example? Okay, we'll take the example of, we'll take the example of pharmaceutical and chemical. In pharmaceutical and chemical, suppose we can take the value of, you have exported the 1 crore FOB value of pharmaceutical products to overseas country. So in that case, MEIS incentive was around 3%. So on 1 crore, MEIS was getting around 3 lakhs rupees. But in the roadmap, there is no incentive. Roadmap is no applicable. So they will get a zero incentive, because that is not covered in roadmap. Suppose any product is covered in roadmap, I will show you there are some few slides. I will share you what is the rate, how to calculate the incentive rate in roadmap. That I am going to share you. Incentive roadmap is less than, yes, Aditya, you are right. It is very less. If you can see the benefit, point number three, the benefit range between 0.01 to 4.3% of FOB. However, in majority of the products, benefit under roadmap is substantially lower, maybe less than 50% than MEIS benefit. Okay, we are a merchant of automobile parts. As you mentioned, steel is not covered in this scheme. So it is about raw material or finished product. So it is about the steel only. A processed product is getting, I am going to share you at the end of the session, I am going to share you that para, all the 8,555 tariff details, where incentive, they have mentioned the incentive, or you can also give me the HS code during the presentation. I will tell you whether it is applicable or not. Just keep your ready HS code. Okay. So we'll move on to the further point. So which one is not covered in this roadmap? Steel, pharmaceutical and chemical is not covered. If you want to understand, need to refer Appendix 4R dated 17 August 2021 to access the details. We are having that. We are going to cover this. We will show this Appendix 4R in next 4 to 5 slides. So we'll discuss the custom parts. What are the duties of the customs? So there are custom duties are basic duty, that is additional basic custom duty. Then there is a 10% social welfare on the custom duty. Then there is an anti-dumping duty, safeguards duty, countervailing duty, and GST. So these are the custom duty. And what is the mechanism of refund? How to take that custom duty refund? You can refund through the all industrial drawback, brand rate of drawback. Also, if you are an export-oriented unit or special economic zone, or if you have taken an advance authorization or EPCG license, in that case, you do not need to pay the any custom duty. So these are the custom duty, and this is the mechanism of refund. If you are importing, the goods, and if you want to take the refund of the custom duty, so under this, you can take the refund of the custom duty. So this is a custom duty. And what are the central, which are the duties, central duties and taxes merge under GST? Kaun sa duties and taxes, central taxes and duties merge with the GST? We'll see central excise duty, including additional excise duty, which was already merged into GST. Service tax was a tax which was levied by the government on services provided. That is also merged with the GST. So there is no separate excise duty and service tax. Also, additional custom duty. It was also duty equivalent to the central excise duty, which was imposed on manufacturing. That is also merged with the GST. Now we understand that GST mein kaun sa taxes and duties merge ho chuke hai. Special additional duty of custom, it was also payable at 4% on goods imported and diseases instead of VAT and sales tax. That is also merged with the GST. Central surcharge and cess. Surcharge was a charge on tax, as the name suggests. It is an additional charge. Cess was imposed by the central government and is levied for specific purpose. That is also covering to merge with the GST. State. There are some state duties and taxes that is also merged with the under GST. You must know that there is a only right now there is a only one tax, that is a one country one tax, that is a vision of the current government. So they have converted all various taxes, duties and taxes, and merged with under GST. So what is there? There is also value added tax, tax on the goods and services that were provided, that is also merged with the GST. There is a central sales tax that is also merged, octroi and entry tax, purchase tax, luxury tax, taxes on lottery, betting and gambling, entertainment tax. And what is the mechanism of refund of that tax? Either you can get the input credit on GST. So that is the mechanism of the all merge tax, and you can take the input against the GST. So this is the mechanism. What is not covered for refund under GST? Which are the taxes not covered and still there? There is a taxes on alcoholic liquor for human consumption, 5 petroleum products, namely crude oil, petroleum, high speed diesel, motor spirit, petrol, aviations, kept out of GST. Neither goods or services, sale of land, building, employee, employer, court services, services by legislative, funeral service, etc. These are the goods and services exempted from the GST. So these are the taxes we have to pay it, whether you are an exporter or not. So these are the taxes we have to pay. Just understand it. Why we are telling this? So it is a link to the road tax scheme. So we are explaining this part. Are you clear on this part as on today parts? Which are the taxes were merged with the GST and which are still not merged and not refunded under GST? Ye clear hua aapka? Okay, Siddharth. Anybody? Okay. Yeah, it is very important to understand kaun sa merge hua hai, kaun sa nahi merge hua hai. So, okay, so we'll move on to the next part. What is the road tap principle? Refund currently unrefunded. Matlab, these are the taxes which are unrefundable. Wo kaha se, there is no mechanism to get the refund. So these are the taxes. Lekin, if you see the export ka basic export ka kya hai? When we export to overseas country or our products and services, so no taxes is applicable. Export ke liye there is no taxes. This is a principle of our foreign trade policy. Lekin, these are the some taxes. Suppose hum kuch petrol kharite for the business purpose and hum export karte on transport ke liye gaadi jata hai. So fuel, we use the fuel, natural gases. So we are unable to take the refund on that. Fuel ke upar jo taxes hai, we are unable to take, we are not taking the refund of that. सो लेकिन एक्सपोर्ट का बेसिक प्रिंसिपल क्या है, वट एवर वी एक्सपोर्ट नो टैक्सेस इज एप्लीकेबल, नो ड्यूटीज एंड टैक्सेबल एप्लीकेबल फॉर द एक्सपोर्ट. लेकिन दीज आर द टैक्सेस वी आर पेइंग. सपोज इफ यू आर अ एक्सपोर्टर एंड आपने सपोज ये पेट्रोलियम प्रोडक्ट्स खरीदे किया, मैन्युफैक्चरिंग किया, फ्यूअल नेचुरल गैसेस किया, तो उसके ऊपर आपने टैक्स पे किया है और आप एक्सपोर्ट कर रहे हैं और यू आर नॉट गेटिंग द रिफंड. सो इन दैट केस रोडटैप फर्स्ट प्रिंसिपल इज टू गेट द रिफंड करंटली विच इज अनरिफंडेबल. हैव यू गॉट दिस पॉइंट? हैव यू गॉट दिस पॉइंट? प्रिंसिपल व्हाई रोडटैप इज देयर. नेक्स्ट इज ड्यूटीज टैक्सेस लेवीज एट द सेंट्रल स्टेट local level borne on the exported products, prior stage cumulative indirect taxes on goods and services used in the production of the exported products, such indirect taxes, duties and levies on distribution of export products. So this we should get the refund, because principally export ke liye there is no taxes, lekin ye taxes hame jo pay karte hai to wo hame refund somewhere, we have to get the refund. Abhi MEIS to hame, MEIS to replace ho chuka hai, MEIS abhi incentive scheme nahi hai. तो देर आर सम टैक्सेस विच आर वी आर नॉट गेटिंग रिफंड. तो इसलिए गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया फॉरेंटेड कॉमर्स मिनिस्ट्री हैज सेट अप दिस रोड टैप स्कीम. व्हाट इज मीन बाय एम्बेडेड टैक्स? एम्बेडेड टैक्स मींस विच इज अनेबल टू रिफंड. जो हमने टैक्स डिस्कस किया राइट नाउ विच इज अनेबल टू रिफंड, प्रायर स्टेजेड टैक्सेस विच आर नॉट अलाउड टू बी ऑफ सेट ऑफ और वी कैनॉट टेक द रिफंड, GST on input used in the final product which is exempted, GST on input used in the final product which is not covered under GST. So there are some taxes which we are unable to take the refund. It is called the embedded tax. So these are the embedded taxes. So we should get the refund. So this is the basic principle of the taxes not refunded under present mechanism. Kaun sa hai? VAT on fuel, mandi tax, duty on electricity charges, stamp duty on export documentation, embedded GST paid on inputs such as pesticide, fertilizer used in production of agriculture goods, embedded GST in purchase from unregistered dealers, embedded GST on coal used in production of electricity, embedded GST on inputs for transport sector, VAT on fuel used in generation of captive power. So these are taxes not refundable under present mechanism. So there is no mechanism, but many of the exporter use these services, use these products, so they should get that benefit. They should get that refund. Also, central excise on duty on fuel used in transport, embedded CGST paid on inputs such as pesticides, unregistered user that we have already covered. The what is the road tap scheme? So these are the some taxes which is not covered. So what is the road tap scheme? So we'll discuss in detail. What is a road tap scheme? Road tap scheme is a made of operation from 1st January 2021 through press release and advisory by Ministry of Finance, though the rates are still to be announced. So ye 1st January mein scheme hua tha, to road was still to be announced. Now they have announced the rate. Notification, this notification received from the DGFT, coverage of products already covered in the appendix 4R, notify on 17 August 2021. No separate code or serial number needed. Code given in the shipping will suffice. Ineligible categories. What are the ineligible categories? That is EOU, who were the export oriented unit, who has taken the advance authorization scheme, job done from the others. Certain ineligible category, as we discuss, chemicals and chemicals, pharmaceuticals, and steel that are not covered. So what are the appendix 4R that we will see it in details. What is the taxes and how to calculate the taxes? Can you see this? You can put it in chat box. Can you see this? Okay. So appendix 4R notified on 17 August under notification number 19/2015-20 oriented policy. Scheme for remission of duties and taxes on exported products. How to calculate that? That we will see it right now. How to calculate that? So we can take the example of. You can also give your HS code number. Anybody? You can give your HS code number. I think somebody has given the HS code number. We'll see. Okay. 8708. We'll see. We'll see the 8708. Okay, 8708. Okay, so 8708 is, can you see this? Parts and accessories of the motor vehicles, heading 8708. So it is having bumpers and parts, thereby it is having a road tap skin of 0.5%. 0.5%. All 8708, it is having a 8708 4000 gearbox and parts, it is having 1.4%, 0.9%. Are you getting this? 8708, Suhaji, are you getting this? 8708 4000, it is having 1.4% of FOB value. So it is one of the good. Suhaji, it is 1.4. Raman 720740, we'll see that. They are saying no match. 7207. Road tap entry number. No, they have not given. Raman, I think there is no 7207 not cover. We'll discuss in detail. That is not cover. We'll see the 7389. We'll see the 7389. I think that is also not cover. 73 is not cover. We'll see. I think that is not covered. We'll take the 8512. If you see the 8512, it is come under electrical and lighting, so it is a 0.9%. It is having 0.9%. Earlier it might be having 3%, so it is a 0.9%. So have you got it? So this is the, I will share the, or you can also find out the appendix 4R in Google. You will get it from DGFT side. So these are the incentive scheme. You can check it off your HS code. Is that okay? So we'll move to the next part of the presentation. So this is the road tap scheme and how to find out the, and this is ineligible categories are, if you are an EOU, if you are taken an advance authorization scheme, or if you are taken the EPCG scheme, then you are unable to, you are not eligible for the, get the road tap scheme. How to get that road tap scheme? Whenever you file the shipping bill, in that case, you have to make a yes. You have to make a yes if road tap is available. Road tap is if not available, you have to put the yes in shipping bill. Whenever you file the shipping bill, you will get a checklist from the custom house agent, and you have to see that we have mentioned yes, road tap is available. That we have mentioned it. This is the road tap. This is the code that CH has mentioned, that we have to check it. Statement code is RD001. Just we have to ensure that yes is mentioned in road tap. So this is the way you can claim, and we can claim. This is the one of the way to claim the road tap. Shipping bill are sent to, what is the process? Shipping bill are sent to the RMS after EGM filing. If clear, shipping bill is queue for scroll, else it will come back to the offer and further details. So EGM export general manifest has to be filed after filing the shipping bill, all data to be shipping line, all data to be intimated to the customs. So it is called EGM. EGM has to be filed, has to be done. You should have ICEGATE account. Whoever are the exporter, have you done the registration for the ICEGATE? Because it is very important to do the registration for the ICEGATE. Okay, very good, Bhagyalakshmi. Because this is this will be, you can view it in on ICEGATE. It is available on the ICEGATE. Once the road tap rates are notified, system will automatically calculate the rates for all the items in the shipping bill on which road tap was claimed. Your job is to just put yes while filing the shipping bill. Then automatically rate will be calculated and it will be reflected on your ICEGATE portal. So how to transfer the duty slip? So we'll discuss how to transfer that duty slip. First, you have to do the registration to the ICEGATE. Then we have to go to the what is the process of registration? Registration processes. You should have a DSC. You should take the DSC digital signature. Then you have to go and register on the ICEGATE. ICEGATE after and download the that software, and you can register that. After getting a login and a password, you can view your shipping bill. You can also view your bill of entry. Also, you can view all road tap related schemes. So these are the first step of getting the registration to the ICEGATE. After doing the registration, after a credit ledger account, you can create a credit ledger account, which is created. You can view it in following details, that is scroll details, slip details, transaction details, transfer slip, approved transfer slip. So that is easily available. Basic thing is, first thing is, you have to ensure that while filing the shipping bill, you have mentioned the road tap available, yes. And then you have to go to the ICEGATE, and you have to, this is the way, scroll details, slip details, transaction detail, transfer slip, approved transfer slip. After login, you will get the, all the details. After scroll details, you have to keep the tab, you have to click on the tab, and you can do the process. All the instructions given on the that ICEGATE portal, so you can easily find out that how to do that. This is the process given, how to transfer the license, how to transfer the script, and how to use for the another IC holder. You can transfer this script, whatever script has reached you, you can transfer the script to another IC holder. You can also sell that script to another IC holder, or you can use that script to pay the import duty amount for your own. So this is the benefit of the this is the way you can convert, you can encash it, that the that script, duty script, as per the as we used to do it for the MEIS. It is the same process of the MEIS, but you can do it your own. Earlier for MEIS, we have to do the application to DGFT. Now we don't need to go for the DGFT. You can do it your own, or you can take the support of the any other service providers. So these are the transaction details of, and you can, after login, you can process that it. So you can, after having a ICEGATE registration, you can process the, and this is the, we have mentioned that how to transfer and what is the process, that already explained in the ICEGATE. So now I am not going to explain this. It is the same process like a MEIS process. So what are the issues? We'll discuss what are the issues of the road tap. Road tap being duty rebate scheme should not be limited by the budget constraint. That is the issue. They have not given the, it should not be budget. The rates may be notified in 4 to 6 digits so as to reduce the fixation work and provide flexibility to exporter. Provide road tap benefit to, because they have not given the road tap, not given to benefit, not given to the advance authorization. There are EOU, special economic zone. Also suffer embedded tax and also incur taxes on fuel, both for inward and outward transportation. These are the point not covered. That issue as flagged by the Federation of Indian Export Organization. Transition mechanism to cover these those cases where shipping bills were filed before 31st December 2020, but LEO issued on 1st January, that still that issue is pending. So how to do that? That issue has been flagged by the FPO. Allow the benefit of road tap for shipment through courier and foreign post office by modifying CSB fee and PBE2. There are some export through the courier and foreign post office. That is also not covered. Dispense with the need of having road tap declaration in the shipping bill and allow the benefit without declaration when road tap rates are notified subsequently. What PO says, why we are giving, why we have to do the mark the yes available on shipping bill? Because it is, it should be automated. It should be automated. We should not give the, we should not put the yes. We do not need to put yes. So that is the flag point issued by the given to, by the PO to the Commerce Ministry. Dispense with RMS after EGM has RMS has already applied before the LEO and it will be simply lead to delays. There is some process that that also should remove. Correct the ad hoc entitlement as software is sometimes wrongly calculating the road tap. So sometimes that that doesn't, that software doesn't calculate the amount, incentive amount. So that should be corrected. So this is the issues flagged by the PO. So what are the issues? Current issues are steel, chemical, and pharmaceutical sectors out of new duty remission scheme, not out of the duty remission scheme. So that they are, this is the just today's news. They are going to meet to the Commerce Minister. Why we are not involved, pharma and not involved in this scheme, because that is also one of the biggest contributor to the exports. But what Commerce Ministry says, in financial year 2020, their aim is to achieve $400 billion export, and export growth as compared to last year, it is 39.51%. So export is growing. So that might be the reason. They are gradually removing the incentives from the few sectors like pharma, chemical, and because that sector has grown drastically during this COVID period. So that might be reason, because export benefit should get, incentive should get to the sectors which government of India is promoting. These are sector already achieve good amount of exports, so they might have, government might have removed the from the road tax scheme from pharmaceutical, chemical, and steel sector. So that might be the reason they have removed it. But my views is that gradually all incentives and incentive schemes, they are going to remove, because our country is in a process to be developing country, to the developed country. So all incentive might be after 2 or 3 years, it might be removed. So right now it is available and we are getting 0.91%. So one of my colleague, he's a manager in one of the MNC companies, he said that I'm so surprised and I'm so happy that they have given the at least good amount of incentive, like 0.14%, 0.9% and 0.5%. He was expecting that it will get more than, less than 0.5%. So that was his views, but he's happy that he said that at least we have got the, getting the 0.9 or 0.5% incentive. So this is the about road tap. So my view also, I have shared my views. So how to go forward? These schemes are going to, as time goes, these schemes will be removed. This incentive scheme will be removed gradually. So how to way forward? Because our country is going to be in a process to going to be a developed country. So what should be the way forward, that we will discuss, rather than issues we have to discuss. So what is the challenges of the exporter and how to way forward? Challenges of the exporter is they are not, whatever my observation, they are not doing the market research properly. They are not assured about the payment. They don't have knowledge about the export and import. So these are the challenges. So how to way forward? Because these are the these types of schemes are gradually, or these are the types of scheme gradually they are reducing the their incentives, so that there is a very less scope for the getting the incentive in future also. So how to way forward to get the more benefit? So we should focus on more and more focus on the export and export development, export business. So we should learn the how to do the market research, how to assure about the payment, how to learn export and import. That way we have to way forward so that we will achieve our vision to make an export rich India and will be in a surplus for the foreign exchange. So how to do that? So right now, if you are there, so I share you how to do the market research for your products. That I will share. Anybody can give your HS code. I will tell you how to do the market research. how to do the market research, because market research is one of the important points. How to do the market research? Anybody can share your HS code? I'll share you how to do the market research. Anybody is fresher there? Anybody wants to do the, how to do the market research? Because if your knowledge, if you have done the market research, 8708, okay, we'll see the 8708. If you do that, parts and accessory, trade indicators. We will see the 8708. What is the potential of 8708? If you see that, potential is around 33,92,51,582,000 is the potential world is importing this product, 8708 product. If you see Germany, that also that they are also United States of America, this product is importing in few lakhs crore. So these are the market potential. You have to see the what is the market potential, and we have to target for the developing or the exports. Like you can see also companies. What are the companies they are importing this 8708 product? You can go here and you can see the companies. You can go through this and you understand what is the product potential. So these are the companies are importing countries. We'll see this auto and home supply 7130 are companies. You can find out the company. You can go through the website and you can contact them directly. So you can directly contact to the actual importer of the. So these are the Hungary-based companies. Company name is given. Which city is also given. So these are the Hungary-based companies. You can contact them. So this is the way everybody can see. Everybody can check. Go through the trademap.org. Find out the what is the market potential. Find out the companies, and you can directly connect to the that buyer, and you can focus on the export. Are you getting this? Are you okay with this? Have you understood? Do you have any question on this? Also, you can see the what is the export potential. You can click here and you can find out the what is the export potential of your respective HS code products. Of your HS code, you can also find out the HS code. I have just given the demo. So this is the way you can find out the what is the potential of export, and you can focus more on the export part to make a export reach India. Going to the last slide. What are the ways to get connected with the overseas buyer? So these are the some ways to find out the international buyers, like friends and relatives. Data says can you see this? Sorry. So, I'll explain it again. So these are the various ways connecting with the friends and relatives, doing the correspondence with the overseas buyer, personal visit, agents, exhibition and trade fairs, participating in the delegations. So these are the various ways to get connected with the overseas buyer. So these are the things, and also these are the ways to get connected to the overseas buyer. So our suggestion or conclusion is to more focus on more and more to getting the connected with the overseas buyers, and focus on the export to make export reach India, so that we can achieve our export reach India vision. These are the schemes. Right now it is available. It is this road tap scheme is applicable only for this 1 year. After 1 year, rate might get changed, rate might get up or might get reduced, that we don't know about it. So this is the road tap scheme, and we'll review, we discuss on the objective and vision, India's contribution against world GDP, actual facts and figures, various export incentive scheme, various taxes merged under GST, road tap principal schemes and rates, how to avail export import incentive, challenges of exporter, various way to get connected with the buyers. And whatever support you require, we are ready to support you regarding the export and import. If you want how to get connected with the buyers, that also will support you in this session. So do you have any questions as on today? You can ask the questions. This forum is open for the Q&A. Any questions? Right now it is audible. There was some disconnection in the my internet. Right now it is audible. Okay. So have you listened? What are the ways to get connected with the buyers? From which steps it was disconnected? Okay. So do you have any questions? We discuss on the various parts of the incentive schemes, what is the World Trade Organization, their roles, and how to connect with the international buyers. Any question regarding this? You can ask the questions. Aapko kisi ko question puchna hai, you can ask the questions. Do you have any questions? You can ask the questions. Rahulji, I'm allowing you to become a panelist. Rahulji, are you there?
Yes.
I think there is no question. If you have any question, you can put it in the chat box. Yes, there is a green chili powder. There is a lot of potential is there. You can check it on the trade map. What is the market potential of green chili powder? You can check it on the trade map. Also, there are some other sites. You can... There are some other sites where you can find out if we can do the market research. Anybody is having any questions? You can ask. Do you have any questions regarding road tap, specific to road tap? Okay, no. Okay, Raman. Thank you, Raman. So, Rahulji, over to you. I am making you name sticks. Yes. There is a good opportunity for name stick. I'm making a course.
Yes.
So thank you.
Am I audible?
Yeah, you are audible.
Yes. Thank you so much, Manakji. This session was very fruitful. Learned something new today. And hope we do organize this kind of session again and again. We would love to explore more regarding, and it seems to be that this field is very new to us, and we can achieve more. We have so much opportunities, and the future is great. in India. The session was very informative and I liked it.
Thank you. Thank you, Rahulji. Thank you, Rahulji, and thank you, IBC, for giving me the opportunity to share my views about the road tap. Also, thank you to all participants for your patience being here and giving your valuable time to attend these sessions. Also, you can follow our, we conduct these types of sessions, mini sessions. You are requested to follow our 24-mile social media platform, YouTube, Instagram, Facebook. So we'll get an update of these types of all sessions. You'll get an update. Also, you can follow social media platform of the IBC. You will get an update of such types of sessions. So thank you very much. If you have any questions, query, you can log into our 24-mile portal website and you can connect with our office. They will reply to your queries. So thank you very much, Rahulji, IBC, and all participants. For I'll put my, you can log into our website. You will get all the details. It is a www.24thmile. I'll put it 24thmile.com. And you can also mail sales@24mile.com. You can mail it to this if you have any questions. You can contact. Also, we are available on sale number, mobile number, that is put it on the website. So thank you again for your time. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, everyone.
Okay. Thank you.